it starts off with 3 solid minutes of this garbage-ass 90s song for these fucking opening credits. This shit is way too long, bro. What the fuck be wrong with people? Nobody likes long-ass opening credit scenes. Don't put that shit in your goddamn movie, please. I'm sorry. Wesley Snipes is the main character, I guess. He a drug dealer, and he ruthless and bought his money or whatever it looks like. He got a fucking Gumby or whatever you want to call this ugly-ass shit on his head.
See ya! And I wouldn't want to be.
We see him hanging this random white dude by his feet from a bridge for some reason. For money, probably. It's probably for money.
You don't have my product, and you don't have my money.
You gotta give me another chance!
See ya! And I wouldn't want to be.
We at the park now. It's the 80s. It's like a flashback or something. Ice-T is here. Fake dreads. He trying to buy a bunch of drugs from Chris Rock. He in the movie. This nigga got the skinniest head I ever seen. Y'all should donate now, please. Join the movement, please.
Come again, come again.
You know, this ain't Delancey Street, and you ain't about to Jimmy down. And that's my price, man. Take it or leave it.
Yo, let me see the money. Let me see the money. What's up?
What you know about that, homeboy?
Chris Rock's stunt double is getting low on this nigga Ice-T at first, until he comes across this comically long stairway. You know, a little planning would have helped. He should have had an escape route picked out or something. You gotta be prepared, bro. Why do you wait till they got to this crowded ass park to shoot this nigga?
Punk blast, Miss Dope Fiend, bitch! Spit in my face, man! I'm finna kill him!
Yo, man, you fucking that kid up!
And he kicking his monkey ass!
Is he, though? Is he fucking him up? This nigga kinda just fake tugging at his shirts. I mean, he shot him, I guess. What the fuck are they talking about? He not beating him up at all. I guess that's just how movies used to be. Fucking fake looking.
Kicking his monkey ass!
Jason Lyric in the movie. He part of Wesley Snipes' crime team. They all a crime team. They the fucking Kango boys or something. They all wearing Kangos and shit. They all at a crime meeting now, I guess you would call it. Wesley Snipes is talking about his plan to buy some apartment complex and sell drugs out of it. He gathered his whole gang of criminals here, and they all got different personalities. There's Radio Raheem. He's stuttering really bad, and something might be wrong with him mentally.
He's a genius, man. Pure under... Man, would you please shut the fuck up?
Also, they got a girl criminal. She's supposed to be funny or cool or something. She is neither.
I'm just singing that fat bitch a lullaby.
Rock a ball, baby.
One place to make the product. One place to collect our money. We will own this fucking city. Damn. Crap.
Message! Before Wesley Snipes does his evil, dark-skinned nigga plans, they gotta tie up a few loose ends. They shoot a Jamaican nigga or something. It's good fun.
Your services are no longer needed in the community.
Ooh, the bomba clotting.
Yeah! Now that's how you kill somebody, my brother. Throw his brains all over the sidewalk in broad daylight.
Rock the ball, baby.
Bro, that's crazy. I did not put that sound clip in there. That rockabye baby shit, that's part of the movie. I deadass was about to put that shit there, though. Like, exactly right there. That's hilarious. That's great comedic timing. I find it fascinating that niggas used to actually do this. Niggas hanging out, singing with the homies, with a trash can fire and shit. I can't imagine that shit. How is that fun? You're probably disturbing people and shit also a little bit.
Oh, yeah.
They have their crack montage. Everybody turning into crackheads. The city turned to a crack city. These singing niggas crackheads also now. You know, this shit really happened to places though. Like a lot of places. It wasn't that long ago either. That's pretty sad. Sad hood. Real life. It's later now. Ice-T is staring at some little kids at the playground. Like staring super hard. It's super weird. What the fuck is wrong with this nigga?
We climb up to a higher station. A new spiritual.
He sees some empty crack vials on the ground and he's sad now. The kid smoked all the crack or whatever. The scene ends there too. Like, he don't talk to nobody. I really don't think he knows these little kids, bro. We cut to the police station and there's some random cops trying to stop Wesley Snipes or something. It's super generic cop shit. It's terrible. Everybody's hair is fucking awful. Like, look at this nigga. How the fuck he even do that shit?
Oh my God.
That's legit Donald Trump hairstyle. That's a boy perm and shit. Look at this nigga mustache, bro. This man look like a cartoon train conductor. What the fuck is this costume design?
I need some results. Fast.
The generic cop guy gets his funding or whatever the fuck to stop Wesley Snipes. I don't know. He wants Ice-T to go undercover with this crazy white dude.
So what's the catch?
Freddy here goes with you.
This big biscuit head looking.
Hey.
There's some Italian drug dealers now. They want to team up with Wesley Snipes, but he being an asshole to them.
You fucking guys are cutting us out of our agreed upon 10%.
You come back and you see me next week, right? And I'll hook you up with some of them collard green linguinis and shit. Chitlins Alfredo.
Chris Rock shows up again and he a crackhead now. And in case you forgot his whole entire story, Wesley Snipes recaps that shit for you. That's very nice of him.
First, you want to be a stick-up kid, right? But then you got shot. Now you's a base head.
Oh, shit. That's the kid I shot. I'm gonna keep an eye on that kid.
You don't deserve that turkey no more. See, it's my turkey. My friend! Get the fuck
You little punk-ass chump. Beat up a girl if it's in turkey. Use a poor excuse for a brother.
Ah, shit, man!
Ice-T's acting is pretty atrocious. Chris Rock and most of the other main characters are doing a solid job, but Ice-T is bringing every scene down like 10 notches.
This crack shit, man, it's got me, man. I don't got no control over it, man. Shit, this be calling me, man. Be calling me, man.
They have this weak-ass Chris Rock detox montage. It's supposed to be deep and powerful. It's not that good, though. Chris Rock gets clean and he starts snitching on Wesley Snipes. They turn those apartments into a super high-tech crack fortress. Niggas got key cards and shit.
Man, that's where they actually make the crack. Yo, it's crazy because I heard they got everybody in their butt naked. Nino don't trust a motherfucker.
Nino's one sick genius.
Yeah, back to the titties.
Fuck no. First off, this fucking hair, bro. I can't with the hair. And the dancing. And she got like a long ass face. I'm not trying to go in on this lady or nothing. But they high key playing this shit up like she's super bad or something. I, 90s bad, maybe. I disagree. Wesley Snipes has a girlfriend apparently, or a wife or something. She this lady, I guess. We like 40 minutes in. I feel like she should have popped up sooner.
Man, would you please shut the fuck up?
Regardless, she's here at their secret base or whatever. She's being super mean to that one long-faced lady.
Yo, G-Money, I like this girl of yours.
He ain't got no papers or a leash on me. Well, you know what happens when dogs don't have a leash.
A man like you, Nino, needs to leave a legacy. A son, a mark to let the world know that he was here.
I mean, it ain't like I ain't been trying. Hey, she can't have no kids, man. She can't fuck either, huh?
What you think, man? Hey?
This nigga Wesley Snipes start tripping. He being mean to his wife and his best friend, Jason Lyric. He's starting to get a little bit weird, like every rich person in the world. That should make you weird for some reason.
Yo, Pookie, come here, man.
This kid I was telling you about, Pookie, he been bringing us a lot of business.
Well, today's your lucky day, homeboy, because I'm going to promote your ass.
All right.
The cops put a wire on Chris Rock and send him into the crack fortress. He gets promoted to crack bagger, and now all he got to do is get some video and not get caught and not smoke the crack.
Everybody, hey, scream.
Oh, hold on.
One and a two and a three and a four. What y'all looking at? Get up.
There's something wrong with your guy, Scotty.
What's wrong with you, fool?
You a high motherfucker.
What, you 5-0?
Oh shit, his cover's blown.
Scotty, help me, I'm gonna die.
Everybody pays.
You know, why was he the only one allowed to wear clothes? The reason everybody is naked is so they can't steal shit.
That does not make sense.
I don't know.
3 seconds left.
Operation was a failure, man. Did you get any evidence?
Ice-T and White Capio decide to go rogue or something and kill Wesley Snipes. They grab up one of the Italian niggas from earlier and force him to help.
Oh. Behind door number one, your head explodes like a melon.
Behind door number two, you hook us up with G-Money, get the prize, Nino Brown.
Italian Yo hooks them up with Jason Lyric first, and they promise to cut him a side deal or something. He's going rogue also, and he's smoking crack, and he also upset that his friend is powerful and be tripping.
Sit your $5 ass down before I make change.
And he fucked his bitch also.
Whoa, y'all, I'm here to see G-Money.
Hold up, I know him, he's cool, he's all right.
Now, I know you're supposed to be my man's new contact, but I don't trust you.
Wesley Snipes decides to give Ice-T a shot at being his new plug. One of them super light-skinned, the other one super dark-skinned. Is good versus evil. It's a metaphor, probably. I don't know.
Two for you.
Junior!
You're committing genocide on your own people with your silk suits and fancy cars.
Yo, you better step off, Grandpa. Yo, Nina, let me smoke this old dude.
Use the fool, old man.
That's it.
Don't even try it, old man. Don't even think.
Old man really wanted to do me, didn't he?
Old bastard.
Bro, this nigga Wesley Snipes is hardcore hanging out with this rando he just met. That shit was instantly too. You letting random niggas get close to you after everything that just happened? You should be expecting more undercovers, bro. Has he even provided you with any drugs yet? If he did, they didn't show that shit. How did this drug empire get so far? This shit looks super easy to infiltrate.
Hey, you can't trust anybody these days, huh?
Trust me. I got your back.
They had some wedding now. Wesley Snipes is paying for the wedding or sponsoring or crack sponsor. This nigga Keith Sweat is here making a cameo. This nigga kinda too hilarious for words. I can't explain it, but this nigga is very funny to me.
Now Reverend Oates would like to say a few words to the happy couple.
I need somebody just like you, girl.
Some random Italians attack the wedding. The rockabye lady gets shot. Fucking thank God. That bitch annoying.
Step the fuck off, Gigantor.
Wesley Snipes picks up some little girl and uses her as a shield like a goddamn G. She doesn't get shot though. Ice-T saves her. You should have fucking... Where's Keith Sweat? Protect him first, bro. Before anything. He a national treasure.
Thank you.
You're a murderer, Nino! I've seen you kill too many people, Nino!
Hey, real quick, look at how poorly dubbed her lines are right here.
I've seen you kill too many people, Nino!
Ice-T tries one last time to set up a drug deal to catch Wesley Snipes.
What's up, fellas?
Park, what the fuck is taking him so long? Nino's not moving.
Shit. Let's do this.
Bro, this nigga head is all the way in the window. Did Wesley Snipes' team not secure this area or something? Like, how does nobody see him?
Yo, I knew Washington. Yo, he's 5-0, man.
Punch it!
Here you go.
Wesley Snipes escapes. The stuttering nigga gets killed. Everything falling apart. And now it's only Wesley Snipes and Jason Lyric left.
You cut a side deal with that motherfucker, didn't you? Yes, you did.
Man, we all we got. Am I my brother's keeper?
Yes.
This nigga Ice-T has clearly run out of ideas on how to catch Wesley Snipes. He resorted to flat out asking random strangers on the street where he is.
You know where Nino Brown lives?
Hey, yo, this dude is a cop, y'all. 5-0. Yeah. I know where Nino lives.
Man, I hope you kill his black-hearted ass. He's upstairs in apartment 6C.
Luckily, the very first people he talks to give him the info, and now him and his white homie are on their way, and they went rogue again. They're gonna get him.
Toss him down to me.
That teacher you killed, that was my mother. I want to shoot you so bad. My dick's hard.
Coming through, excuse me.
I'm gonna do this the right way, man. Come on.
They finally take Wesley Snipes to jail, and he on trial now. He's still got a few evil, dark-skinned nigga tricks up his sleeve, though.
Kareem Akbar. That's right, the educated brother from the bank. He's the real head of the CMB.
If I'm going down, I'll take a whole lot of people.
3 years to life, with parole eligibility after 12 months. Do you understand? Is that clear?
What? All he gets is a year?
Is that how that works? Can you just randomly tell on somebody mid-trial and they forgive you? This nigga ain't even present no evidence.
Mr. Brown, are you pleased with the outcome?
Absolutely. I think the American justice system is the greatest in the world.
Idolater! Your soul is required in hell!
The old nigga ends up shooting Wesley Snipes, and that's how it ends. Hooray for this old nigga. He redeemed himself.
That's it.
This movie's a good watch. It's a nice throwback to the blaxploitation era. You can definitely feel the cheesy 70s pimp daddy type vibe, but it also has that 90s gritty crime drama type vibe, and they blend together well enough. The acting kinda suffers because of the style though. Like, it's kinda wacky and all over the place sometimes. Like, I get what they were doing, but nobody really feels like a real person, you know? A lot of the messages and the social commentary is super on the nose. Again, it's like a blaxploitation thing, so that's how it's supposed to be, probably. Also, it was one of the first big budget movies to focus on the crack epidemic and like black kingpin type shit. Now we've kind of heard it all and know what it is, but for its time, I'm sure it was very prolific. Thanks for watching. Make sure to subscribe and watch everything I ever made. Join me next time for all your favorite hood movies, evil dark-skinned niggas, every dark-skinned nigga an evil person.
He is back to the titties.